Good morning, Reverend Fathers, Sisters, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and welcome to this special morning. We are here today to celebrate a day that holds a special place in our hearts. We are here to applaud the continuous efforts put in by each one of you to make the lives joyful and better for all the children here at Balbhavan. We stand at an illustrious occasion of celebrating 24 years of Father Agnel Balbhavan, and each one of you in the audience is the backbone of it. Therefore, each one of you is our chief guest.
With the immense joy, we take the pleasure of welcoming you to Balbhavan Day 2024. Father Bento has been tirelessly supporting us. His unwavering commitment towards us not only touches our hearts, but leaves an indelible mark in our lives each day. I humbly request you, dear Father, to please come and address the gathering.
Dear Fathers, Sisters, friends, benefactors, our teachers, welcome to this Balbhavan Day. The children already has done that. It's also Lodi, happy Lodi. And she says, each one of you is a chief guest. Very often people ask, who is the chief guest? We have among us the chief guest. The chief guest who has been with us, has been our backbone, has been helping us in one way or other. And this person is besides you. To your, you can see to your left or to your right, and that person is the chief guest. We thank you, and I must say, our children, together with our children, we pray every day for you. This is 24th Balbhavan Day. We did not miss any year. We celebrated Balbhavan Day every year, and this is 24th. So we are entering the 25th year of Balbhavan. Children ask, what is the topic of Balbhavan Day this year? I said, Khichdi. Various programs we have collected, and you will see, you will watch, you will hear. We have collected the music, and in this world, there is a lot of pain, suffering. There is a poem, you will hear that poem also. But in the midst of all this sufferings, we need to be happy. You need to smile. You need to So when we have here, the program is full of items where you need to smile, and when you feel like smiling, laugh loudly. All right. Okay. This decoration was done by our children, 100% by our children. Nothing else, nobody else. Yeah, we worked, they worked, and I was there with them till 1 o'clock last night. And we managed to complete it. I must give you some report. Last year we had 17 students in class 12th. Out of that, 16 cleared, passed. And these 16 are, and they are all first class. There is nobody in the second class. And they are all in some colleges. In Galgotias University, we have three of them, Sharda 1, Delhi University 7, GMC, and Stephens, and the other colleges. Then we have Holy Family doing Nursing 1. Now, up to now, this is what we have. We have 17 teachers. Then 35 doing their private jobs, like we have three lawyers. Then there are two in journalism, working in NGOs, two of them. In one in SBI, he's some manager. He's the first boy from Balbhavan who completed 12th and went ahead. And then he worked, and then he finished his MBA and was selected by State Bank. And unfortunately, he was sick, attacked by COVID, and from one hospital to another hospital to the third hospital in Ames, and ultimately almost at the end, we thought it was the end, and the doctors said, but we in Balbhavan stormed the heavens. We prayed and prayed and prayed, and the miracle was done by God. He revived and came back to life, and he is now working in State Bank of India in Bombay. He has come here. Then we have four in Indian Army. Then self-employed, three are in some jute bag, then farming, then performer, and software engineer. Then hospitality, we have two air hostesses with Air India. And the third one is being trained. The two of them are supposed to come here. I don't know if they have reached. If they have not reached, maybe you will meet them at lunchtime. Then we have six nurses and five students of nursing. 78 graduates, 35 postgraduates. Total number today in Balbhavan is 234, plus those who are living in the hostels. class 10th batch is 11 and 12th batch is 12 students. Two of our girls got married. That is nice, the lawyer. One lawyer who was a lawyer, he got married not even a month back. And the second one married yesterday. We could not go. Then one boy working in Father Agnell school here, sports, and he is associated with Paralympic Committee of India as the national coach. Then we have newborn babies, two of them. One is the boy is ours, and the second one, the boy and girl both are ours from Bal Bhavan. So we have the second grandson, full grandson from both sides. So this is our report to you, and I'm sure with your help, with your support, we will be able to go far, and the children will be able to go far, and I'm sure you will keep us under your support, and we promise you that we will pray for you every day. God bless you.
Thank you, Father. This morning, we want you to set aside all your work, worries, stress, and leave everything out as we bring to you a series of fun and entertaining performances, each showcasing the spirit of our Bal Bhavan family.
Kicking off our celebration is the Bal Bhavan March. Watch our kids march across the auditorium. Watch how they figure out the left and right and walk in a straight line.
Thank you.
These tiny tots were trained by Sir Astony and assisted by Mother Sujata and Alice.
Now, let's lift up our spirits and immerse ourselves in devotion to invoke the blessings of the Almighty as we witness a soulful prayer dance.
Prayer dance was prepared by Sir Sahil and guided by Mothers Maggie and Nirmala.
Taking the stage now is our talented junior choir, leading us to a musical journey where voices synchronize in perfect harmony. Get ready to experience the human harmonies as they sing One Call Away.
Only one call away, and I'll be there to save.
Choir was trained by Father Jovito and Sir Victor.
The beauty of words lie in their ability to paint emotions, to bridge gaps, and to sculpt worlds in the vast canvas of our minds. They carry the power to evoke feelings, ignite imaginations, and connect the intricate threads of human experience. Join me in welcoming Kajal, Monica, and Arnav on stage as they unravel the tapestry of beauty woven in the cadence of poetry. Has humanity failed?
Time is ticking by. The world is standing by. Image is getting worse. Voice is getting hoarse. Children blown to bits. No one calling quits. Humans burned alive. No chance to survive.
Mother screaming pain. Exploded child's brain. Unborn in the womb. Straight to the tomb.
Dreams killed. Ambitions unfulfilled. Shaking from the shock. Death around the clock. Still they insist, toddlers are terrorists. Terror in children's eyes, bombs rain from the skies, calling for their mom who was crushed by a bomb.
You say we terrorize? Come see our skies. Yes, that is a dare. Let's see how much you bear. No gluten for your bread, no graves for our death, no power or water, just barbaric slaughter.
Body parts unclaimed, breathing bodies maimed, the rotten stench of death. No time to catch our breath, no time to mourn or think. More hits before we blink.
Hospitals under attack, trying to make us crack. But little do they know, even an embryo who's born on this land is born to withstand, born to resist with the right to exist.
Resilience is bread, it's our butter and bread. We will not leave our land. Why won't they understand? Threatened by babies, children and ladies. From far the cowards kill. Afraid the truth will spill. They can pay for their lies with their diplomatic ties. But the truth is free with the eyes you can see. Apocalyptic views, yet lies on the news. Are stories for view, not to actually be told.
The media's control, their news is mostly fake. AI photos that they make, we're robbed of dignity, cause we want the world to see. Look, and open your eyes, still, the world denies. The truth is unveiled, humanity has failed.
Give them hope.
They tweet from their rich and comfy seats, hearts hardened and blind, brainwashed, confined. Who gets to decide who's murder justified? Who gets to pick? This all make me sick.
We went back a century. Holocaust, slavery, white superiority. Animals are not so cruel. They don't mock and ridicule. Making TikToks of our pain, that's below inhumane. But the people awaken, outspoken, unshaken.
Go, shut our accounts. We know you know our counts. That's why we're a threat. We simply make you sweat. If the G word is banned, it means you understand there is blood on your hands.
Go censor and delete. Let history repeat.
Politicians two-faced, Our vote, what a waste. They're sly as a fox with their self-righteous talk. There must be judgment day, cause there's a price to pay.
I heard a child scream. I wish it was a dream. This is reality. Shame on humanity.
Time is ticking by. The world is standing by. But decades from today, we can proudly say we feel the fire in our chest and we passed this test. At least we say we tried to end this genocide. Side.
The poem was taught by Sir Joji and his wife, Ma'am Manisha.
Father Jovito, the person who ignites the warmth of love in our hearts with his gentle smile. His lifestyle is marked by a demeanor that is capable of moving mountains. Please join me in welcoming our beloved Father Jovito on stage to address the gathering.
Dear fathers, sisters, well-wishers, benefactors, and my dear loving children, I feel elated and a sense of gratitude fills my heart today to welcome you all over here on this special day. And I would like to thank Ritika for the kind welcoming words. She said that my lifestyle has the power of moving mountains, but I personally feel that as an individual, it is a bit difficult. But however, along with these children over here, anything and everything is possible. And I'm sure there's no doubt about it. Malala, who is a Pakistani female education activist, she also won a Nobel Peace Prize in the year 2014. This is what she says. She says that every child, I dream of a world where they can laugh, dance, sing, learn, live in peace, and be happy. And I think this is exactly what we are doing over here at Father Agnel Bal Bhavan. This is exactly what our children are experiencing here at Father Agnel Bal Bhavan. When I embarked this journey, when I first came to Greater Noida, the very second day someone came to me, and this is what that person said to me. It would be very difficult, Father, for you to handle these children. And I smiled back and said, if God has a plan for me, God will surely take care of everything. And believe me, it has been last 6 months that I'm over here. And I can vouch that the last 6 months have been the best part of my life till today. And simply it is because the each day I spend with these children, they bring this joy in me. They have been a blessing for me. I've experienced the transformative power of care and love amidst the students. I sincerely want to thank the children for their resilience and positivity, which also becomes the reason for all of us today to join with them and gather over here and celebrate this Bal Bhavan Day. Their laughter, their dreams, and their unwavering determination inspires all of us over here to be better caretakers, better mentors, and friends. This journey has been a collective effort, and the credit of our success belongs to each and every child who belongs to this Bal Bhavan family. My heartfelt gratitude also goes out to all our benefactors and well-wishers who are here today amidst us. You have been the pillars of our Bal Bhavan. Your unwavering commitment and kindness have helped us to generate smiles on these faces. Your presence over here today speaks volumes about your dedication to the cause of uplifting our children. It is not only that you all have opened up your hearts, but rather you all have actively participated in bringing joy and making a difference in the lives of our students over here. Today, as we celebrate this Bal Bhavan Day, I also take this opportunity to appreciate the incredible talents that all our students are having. The performance over here is a testament of their creativity, skill, and potential that is there within them. I assure you that the remaining program will continue to entice you and your hearts and minds. So, my dear friends, sit back and relax and continue enjoying the remarkable performances of our students. Thank you, and let the festivities continue. God bless all of us.
Thank you, Father.
Father Bento imparts us with the wisdom. If you win the first fight of the day, you win the day. We would take the pleasure to demonstrate how we handle the first fight of the day.
Let us witness the comical, jocular, and farcical side of the first morning fight with your own bed.
I think you need help to get out of bed. Should I come?
Let us see what goes on inside the mind of the child. Not so early bird.
The early bird catches the worm. Chee! I don't want to eat the worm.
She remembers of a story that was once told by father.
Get up, you need to go to school. Get up and out of bed.
Give me a moment, Mama.
Your moment lasts 1 hour. Get up.
But who has to wake up so early? It should be made illegal. Why do I need to get up?
Because of the principal of the school. Get up.
Oh, I'm neither the principal nor a bright student, but just a sleeping backbencher.
Rise and shine, sleepy Joe. Now's the time, don't you know, to get into a new kind of dream. You've been living alone with no bell telephone, and you don't have a shed that is clean. You can rest your head on the corner of your bed. You can watch the world go by.
Don't you remember what Father Bento advised? If you win the first fight of the day, you will win the day. And if you lose the first fight of the day, you will lose the day. Don't you remember that not waking up on time is a grave mortal sin? The child mumbles.
If I have committed the sin, let me continue it just for 5 minutes more. It can't be worse than the mortal sin. This banging of keys should be reserved for rock concerts, not for morning ritual. So irritating.
It's time for breakfast. Come soon. You need to go to school. The child thinks, yes, father told us that according to the World Health Organization, skipping breakfast is the biggest brain damaging habit, not getting up.
Maybe I should get up now.
This act was supervised by Ma'am NC. Time for a dance, or a dance off, watch the dancers try to outdo each other in the art of mirror reflection. It's like a dance-off, but with their own reflections. All you have to do is imagine a mirror in the center, the mirror dance.
Goes my heart beating, 'cause you are the reason I'm losing my sleep. Please come back now. And there goes my mind racing, and you are the reason that I'm still breathing. I'm hopeless now. I'd climb every mountain and swim every ocean just to be with you and fix what I broke. Oh, 'cause I need you to see that you are the reason.
This dance was choreographed by the children themselves under the supervision of Ma'am Tercy.
Now please join me in welcoming the person whose character is so powerful that he can illuminate the room alone. That man has made the lives of so many people so amazing in so many years and moved so many mountains, I'm sure none of us can count. I request our very dearest Father Carvalho to come on stage and address the gathering.
Thank you, Ritika, for the kind words. Thank you so very much. Thank you, lovely children, for your performances. Let me begin by thanking Father Bento, Father Jovito, the sisters, the wardens, and the mothers, and congratulate them for the wonderful work they are doing. Can I have a standing ovation, please? and to our lovely children here, behind, and everywhere else. Thank you. Please be seated. Every time we come here, I'm lost for words. Once again, I'm lost for words today. Because everyone talks about the miracle of these children, the miracle of the children. And let me spend some time sharing with you about what miracle we are talking about. Life is a miracle. A, because you are God's gift to the world. You have not decided that. God decided for you. And suddenly you find yourself as an adult, even as a child, wondering what you're here for. And please remember, every moment of our life, you have a challenge and the opportunity and the choice to turn that moment into a normal moment or into a miracle. That's what the challenge of life is all about. No one is born to be small. No one is born to be weak. And that is the miracle of, that's the miracle of life again. Imagine people, I'll tell you a story about a young child in England, 8 years old. She's 12 years old now. She has a paraplegic mother. Every morning, she prepares her mother, dresses her up, cleans her up, prepares her breakfast, goes to school, comes back, takes care of his mother. Every action that she does is a miracle. Miracle of commitment, miracle of love, the miracle of a personal conviction. Now, every time we gather here, my dear friends, we have a choice to make this presence here and our opportunity into just another day, another moment, another hour, or turn it into a miracle. The miracle of choices that we make in our lives. When this Balbhavan was inaugurated in 2000, the chief guest was Arun Jaitley, a good friend of ours. And he said something very beautiful. He says, look, government spends crores and crores of rupees in schemes to help people. And look at these guys, we have nothing except the power of their personal belief. Not the personal belief of those who started it, but personal belief in the power of humanity to change the world. And that is what we are talking about today. All of us present here have the power to change the world. Now let's come to the context of today as we decide to celebrate the Balbhavan. We are looking to the children. We see them grow, we enjoy it. We see them sing, we love it. We see them dance, we are amazed at it. We can rest there, or we can make another choice. We can make another choice to make that life beautiful. But you will say to yourself, I don't live in the Balbhavan, I'm far away. I live in Delhi, I live in Noida. And that is where the miracle of opportunity comes. There is nowhere, there is no place, there is no time in the world where you cannot become a miracle to the world by the power of your thought, by the power of your idea. The most powerful, weapon is the wrong word, the most powerful power in the world is the power of your idea. That idea can change the world wherever you are. And you have the power to change the world. That is what is happening here. It was an idea that was launched many years ago. Our founder, Father C. Rodericks, came from Goa to Bombay. He was lost to find a way out. What do I do here? As a priest, I preach the gospel, yes. I live the life that Jesus taught me to live. But what is my challenge here? The challenge was there are children on the streets, on the stations, rummaging through the dustbins for food, for a morsel of bread. That was the miracle that he had to turn. That is the miracle he had to make to turn their life into something different. And that is what I'm talking to you, my dear friends, all of you, including the children. Life is never easy. And it should not be easy. The example of that easiness is to stick to your bed when the bell is out to you to go. That is the negation of life. The affirmation of life is do something that becomes a ripple in the life of those around you. Even in yourself, the idea of doing something better every day, the idea of touching the lives of other people by the mere effect of the thought. You saw the poem? It was primarily the reflection of what's happening in Gaza. Most of the world around us is very, very, very amazed at the power of the Israel, the Israel nation. As a small nation, very powerful, very committed. And when the war began, or when the reaction of the Israeli government to the attack that Gazans took, or the Hamas had against Israel, everyone applauded them. I said on the very first day, the profanity of military might, the consciousness that you are invincible, that you are powerful, there's a beginning of the end. And see what is happening. They don't care how many children they kill. They don't care how many hospitals they bomb. They don't care how many people are going to be killed and maimed and buildings destroyed. The problem was not Israel. The problem is the idea that I can do what I like. Yes, there's a good part of that. I can do what I like. I can do what I like to make the world better. That's a miracle that Pittsburgh can do. Israel could decide to be less aggressive, less brutal, less cruel. But you don't have the capacity to think about the other differently because you think you are more powerful. And the moment you are more powerful, you think I can do what I like. You can't do what you like because our identity as human beings is to be able to create a better human life, a better human nature, better humanity. And that's what is happening right here. Coming back to the miracle of life, my dear friends, please remember as you go out of this place, don't let spark of life that you get today, that something good is happening. Why can't that good happen in my life every day? About the people that you meet, about the people that you deal with, even about the people that you don't deal with. You see a poor person on the road outside. There is nothing you are going to do for him. But can you think about him as a compassionate person? That's what the miracle of life is all about. That is how every good happens. Every good happens because you decide to do that inside your mind first. That is the miracle of life. And there's a miracle of love for which we are born. You know, Jesus was going to Jerusalem and the people around him were claiming, "Hail, King of Israel." He did not like to be praised as a king. And they told him, "Why don't you make these people shut up?" He says, "If these children shut up, the stones will shout." Dear friends, every day we are invited to open our hearts to the realities of the world around us. The realities of the world that are around us. Can I be more compassionate? Can I decide not to hit back when somebody insults me? You know, just now we celebrated Christmas. The miracle, the confusion, and the scandal, and the shock of God becoming man, a child, helpless, wretched. Why did you know why he chose to do that? He chose to carry our sins on him, because that is what God, goodness is all about. That's what God is all about. The power to carry our sins, our failures, our misfortunes. And that's what the example of every human being is all about. Can you carry the burden of others that they put on you, an offense that's done to you? Somebody has done you harm, and you're waiting for a chance to hit back. Can you carry that with you? You change the world. Because you become the miracle of life for that person. And you become miracle of love for yourself. Every time we do good, we become better. That's what we want to wish our children. All these wonderful children who someday will grow up. But let us think, especially those who are in charge of the children. Remember, the world today, my dear friends, is very, very different from the world we had 10 years ago. The World Economic Forum, which is the highest think tank in the world, is putting compassion, solidarity, as the most fundamental skill in the world today, not your intelligence, because AI can do that for you. You don't have to be intelligent today. You have to be compassionate. You have to be understanding. You have to be able to carry other people's problems with you. That is what the world demands. It's not a spiritual teaching. It's the World Economic Forum teaching. That if you want the world to be better tomorrow, you have to learn to be compassionate. You have to learn to be kind. You have to learn to think of the other. And that's how the world will survive today. They're talking of climate change. Climate change cannot be addressed unless you think of someone else. United States emits 16 tons of polluted material in the atmosphere every year, every person in the United States. And Tanzania emits 0.0016 tons. So if America wants to improve America's life, they have to go and help Tanzania. You get it? Humanity cannot grow today without being compassionate. Humanity cannot survive today without making the other person as part of your heritage, of your life, of your survival. That's what we want to, my friends, to understand. Let us go out from here filled with that miracle, the power of human life. I can change the world by the power of the idea. If I have a good idea to change the world, but the world will be a better world tomorrow. I wish you all of that. Thank you. God bless.
Thank you, Father. When we were kids, our parents would buy us toys, which we would keep beating on all day and night, imagining ourselves to be the greatest musicians. We then thought we were creating something, but now I know that something in the grown-ups' language is called noise. Here comes the orchestra, armed with instruments and a knack for turning noises into something more polished that people now call music.
They will be playing Bella Ciao, an Italian protest folk song sung by the Modena workers, and Mukabla by A.R. Rahman.
Thank you.
the band was trained by Father Jovito.
Now, stepping into the spotlight is Himendra, taking us on a journey of laughter with a captivating monologue.
Mike Milke, I like it. Namaskar, respected, esteemed guests, reverend fathers, my dear children, और मेरे प्यारे सुनने वाले साथियों, देखिए, मैं आज यहाँ आप सभी लोगों के सामने चार को रखने आया हूँ। अरे भाई, ये माइक किसने बंद किया? पता है, तुम्हारी इस हरकत की वजह से लोगों ने मेरे विचार को अचार सुन लिया। हाँ, तो भाइयों और मुझे सुनने वालों की बहनों, मैं कह रहा था कि मैं आज यहाँ आप सभी लोगों के सामने थाने आया हूँ। अरे भाई, ये क्या मजाक है? घर में भी मेरी आवाज़ को दबाया जाता है और यहाँ भी तुम भी मेरी आवाज़ को दबा रहे हो। हाँ, तो मैं बता रहा था कि यहाँ आते वक्त मेरे बेटे ने मुझसे एक सवाल किया कि ज्ञान ज़्यादा ज़रूरी है कि पैसा। मैंने कहा ज्ञान नहीं है, पैसा ज़्यादा ज़रूरी है, क्योंकि पैसा कोई नहीं बांटता, पर ज्ञान बेटा सब बांटते हैं। वैसे एक ज्ञान की बात तो चाणक्य ने भी कही थी, जहाँ इज्जत ना मिले वहाँ कभी नहीं जाना चाहिए। अच्छा चाणक्य जी, अब एक बात आप ही बताइए कि शादीशुदा लोग क्या करे, घर ना जाए। वैसे शादीशुदा से याद आया, रिसाइकलिंग आजकल ये शब्द बहुत ज़्यादा कॉमन है। अपने अनुभव के आधार पर मैं बताना चाहता हूँ कि रिसाइकलिंग का मतलब होता क्या है। साइकिल चला चला कर मेरे पैरों में दर्द होने लगा तो बाइक ले लिए, बाइक चला चला कर मेरी कमर में दर्द होने लगा तो कार ले लिए, कार चला चला कर मेरा पेट निकल आया तब जिम चले गए, तब इंस्ट्रक्टर बोला साइकिल चलाओ। तो भैया, जो हम लोग साइकिल से साइकिल पर आए हैं ना, इसको बोलते हैं रिसाइकलिंग। हाँ, तो भाइयों और मुझे सुनने वालों की बहनों, देखिए, वाक्यों में सही जगह विराम देना मतलब पंचुएशन लगाना बहुत ज़रूरी होता है। यदि ये सही जगह ना हो तो अर्थ का अनर्थ हो जाता है। जब मैं फौज में नौकरी करता था तो मेरी बीवी ने बड़े प्यार से मुझे लेटर लिखा, मगर पगली ने सही जगह पंचुएशन मार्क्स नहीं लगाए। उस लेटर को पढ़ते ही मेरे पैरों के नीचे से ज़मीन निकल गई। उस लेटर को अभी तक मैं अपने सीने से लगा कर रखता हूँ। अब आप भी सुनिए, मेरे प्यारे जीवन साथी, मेरा प्रणाम आपके चरणों में। आपने अभी तक चिट्ठी नहीं लिखी मेरी सहेली को। नौकरी मिल गई है हमारी गाय को, बछड़ा दिया है दादाजी ने, शराब की लत लगा ली है मैंने, तुमको बहुत खत लिखे पर तुम नहीं आए, कुत्ते के बच्चे। मेरी सहेली बन गई है और इस समय टीवी पर गाना गा रही है हमारी बकरी, बेच दी गई है तुम्हारी माँ, तुमको बहुत याद कर रही है एक पड़ोसन, हमें बहुत तंग करती है तुम्हारी चंदा चकोरी। अच्छा भैया, अब आप ही बताइए कि अगर सीमा पर रह रहा जवान को ऐसी चिट्ठी मिलेगी तो क्या करेगा? सुबह की ट्रेन पकड़कर जरूर घर वापस आएगा। तो वैसे मैं भी आ गया। खैर, फिर इस चिट्ठी पत्री के बाद आया फेसबुक का ज़माना। मैंने अपनी बीवी को समझाया कि आजकल सोशल मीडिया पर बहुत से ज्ञानी लोग भरे पड़े हैं, जो तुम्हें ज़्यादा ज्ञान दे उसे ब्लॉक कर देना। पर क्या बताऊँ, पगली ने मुझे ही ब्लॉक कर दिया। वैसे क्या आपने कभी गौर किया है कि देश के बदलने वाले अधिकतर नेता कुंवारे हैं या रहे थे, जैसे पूर्व प्रधानमंत्री श्री अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी जी, पूर्व राष्ट्रपति श्री APJ अब्दुल कलाम और अब UP के मुख्यमंत्री श्री योगी आदित्यनाथ कुंवारे हैं। तो भैया, अब तो मुझे ऐसा लगने लगा है कि कुंवारे लोग ही इस देश को बदल सकते हैं। शादीशुदा लोग तो बीवी के रहते TV का चैनल तक नहीं बदल सकते। हेलो, लगता है मैंने कुछ ज़्यादा ही ज्ञान बांट दिया बिना पैसों के। अब मेरे को चलना चाहिए। शुक्रिया, फिर मिलेंगे।
The monologue was written and guided by Ma'am Deepika Sharma.
Now, we have a series of dance forms that are rarely remembered in this age. So we named them the Forgotten Dances. Buckle up, folks, as we are about to resurrect these dance forms. Get ready to witness the salsa. It's so old, it's practically vintage.
Time for a Portuguese dance for an extra dose of entertainment. now is the cha-cha-cha. The steps might be older than the oldest person sitting here. So let's cha-cha-cha.
Throwing in the twist. Lively and dynamic movements and rhythmic beats. Come on, let's twist again.
Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again. Let's twist again.
The students learned the dance forms themselves and were guided by Ma'am Trisha, Ma'am Chen Chen, and Mothers Carolyn and Rina.
A rhyme that resonates with the innocence and charm of childhood. We transform that into a song. Let's hear the choir sing Chubby Cheeks, but with a twist. The lyrics and composition is done by Sir Astony and Father Jovito.
Yes, just we have kept some papers here. You can follow the singing from the papers. Otherwise, you may not get the jokes.
All grown up listening to the classic Que Sera Sera, but our choir brings you the rendition crafted uniquely by them. It sounds like Que Sera Sera, but it's really Wat Lagli, a Marathi version.
Thank you.
Samson was a man of extraordinary strength, and his hair being the source of it. The story unfolds Samson's betrayal by Delilah, who, seduced by the Philistines, cuts off Samson's hair in his sleep. He loses his strength and is captured. He then prays to God for strength. Everything takes a turn when his hair starts growing back, indicating the return of his strength. This is a story from the Bible on betrayal, strength, faith, and redemption.
The next song is a lighter adaptation to the story. Give it up to the choir as they sing Run, Samson, Run, because who doesn't love a good chase, right?
Says to her husband, look at that drunkard, husband. Who is he, wife? 10 years back he proposed me, but I rejected. Husband, oh my God, he's still celebrating?
Did you hear about the drunkard who told himself to stop drinking so much? But he thought, I'm not about to start listening to some drunk weirdo who talks to himself. Next up is the parody of the song, My Way. So apparently, even the afterlife has a sober policy.
Once my life was great, I never had to wash the dishes. I ate off paper plates, and all my laundry smelled like fishes. I lived without a doubt that my way was the sure way. Alas, that is no more. I do things her way. So when I cook an egg, I know not how, so I must boil it.
And woe be to the dread who leaves the seed upon the toilet. The things I put up with, they make me feel I live far away. But she would not approve, that is not her way. Yes, there are times that I watch boats lounging around in undershorts, but it never fails. She wants romance, and that it means I must put on back her favorite pair and comb my hair and comb it her way. And now she seems upset. She hears the things that I am singing. A broom I'll have to get to clean the china she'll be flinging. And then I'll put up shelves because she told me to last Thursday. I'll have it done by 12 and I'll do it her way. The world is a stage, or so I've heard. If that is true, then it's absurd. For I'm a man, oh am I not? I'll take her script and change the plot. I think I'll go and toss that hoe right down the sea.
Get ready for a twist on a classic. We turned O Carol into the anthem of everyone's favorite character, the one and only Karen. O Karen, a melodic journey through trials and tribulations of demanding coffee orders and asking to speak to the manager, the Karen edition, not Carol.
Karen, gossip queen of folk, hated by neighbors, cause you're so untrue. All your says in a barren guy, you're so updated, then you're telling lies. Gossip queen of all, hated by neighbors,
cause you're so untrue. All hearsays in our barangay. You're so dated, then you're telling lies.
Anything you can do, I can do better.
Oh, really? Like what?
I can text 10 girls at once with none of them knowing the others. Oh, I mean, I can dance better, sing better, and even cook better.
But I think anything you can do, I can do better. I can do all of that and multitask.
This debate may never end.
We will carry on.
Meanwhile, we'll give it up for the choirs as they sing anything you can do, I can do better.
Anything you can do, I can do better. I can do anything better than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Anything you can be, I can be greater. Sooner or later, I'm greater than you.
No, you're not.
Yes, sir.
No, you're not.
Yes, sir.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am. Yes, I am. I can shoot a partridge with a single partridge.
I can shoot a sparrow with my bow and arrow.
I can live on bread and cheese.
And only on that?
Yep.
So can a rat. Ha!
Any note you can sing, I can reach higher.
I can sing any note higher than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't. Can you sing so high?
I'm a girl.
Do you think so? Anything you can say, I can say softer.
I can sing anything softer than
you. No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
I can drink my liquor faster than a flicker.
I can do it quicker and get even sicker.
I can open any safe
without getting caught.
You bet.
That's what I thought, you crook.
Any note you can hold, I can hold longer.
I can hold any note longer than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't. Yes, you can. Where do you keep all that air?
In my body cavity.
Oh. Anything you can sing faster.
I can say anything faster than you.
No, you can.
Yes, can. No, can. Yes, can. No, can. Yes, can. No, can. Yes, can. No, can. Yes, can. Yes, can. Yes, can.
I can jump a hurdle.
I can wear a girdle.
I can knit a sweater.
I can feel it better.
I can do most anything.
Can you bake a pie?
No.
Neither can I.
Any note you can sing, I can sing sweeter.
I can sing anything sweeter than you.
No.
know you care.
Yes, I can.
Know you care.
Yes, I can.
Know you care.
Yes, I can.
Know you
yes,
care.
Know
you can't, can't, can't.
Yes, I can, can, can.
No,
yes,
you can.
Now, the next up is In Heaven There Is No Beer. So, grab your imaginary microphones and let's raise the glass to the harmonious escapades, to the intoxicated, they lose their way. It's time for a tipsy serenade.
Ask me, are they all from Balbhavan? They are, including the musicians, except Father Jovito. He is now from Balbhavan. They have grown, and now they are, many of them are working and musicians. So, and they come to help their younger brothers, sisters. Now next is, they will announce, but I must tell you, they are called we call them super seniors. They're all left, finished. Balbhavan, they're out in the colleges and all that, and also working. Some of them are teachers and nurses also. So we could not find a name for them, and that's why we call them super seniors. We have the seniors, class 9, 10th, 11th, 12th, and these are super seniors.
The songs were taught by our seniors, Edwin, Benjamin, and Madhya.
Oh, what a musical roller coaster! But we're not done yet. Please put your hands together for the Super Seniors Choir. They are here to prove that what they lack in practice, they make up for in enthusiasm. And the sheer bravery of facing the crowd after practicing maybe like twice. So sit back, relax, and give a huge round of applause for the bravest choir this side.
Hello, hello.
Sometimes I'm right and I can be wrong. My own beliefs are in my song. The butchers, the bankers, the drummer in them makes no difference what group I'm in.
Now, our students stand before you with words of gratitude.
thank you, God, and you all for your love for us, beloved children. This song was to thank you.
Now we take this day as an opportunity to thank each and every person and organization that has helped us throughout this year. We thank our fathers, Father Bento, Father Carvalho, Father Ro, and Father Jovito, without whom our daily lives are impossible, as they are the pillar of our strength. We also thank our sisters, Sister Nancy and Sister Mina, mothers of Warden, for their unwavering support and guidance.
We are grateful to our didis and bhaiyas who help us in keeping our surrounding clean, assist us in our daily chores like preparing meals for us, driving and repairing things. Appreciation can make our day, even change our life. Your willingness to put it into words is all that is necessary.
We especially thank our benefactors and friends who have helped us generously. With open hearts, may God bless you. The list is huge. Hence, we mention a few, and in their name, we thank you all. Angels Network is truly an angel to all of us. Benefactors from Austria and Germany, hotels, Taj Mahal, Taj Ambassador, Taj Palace Crown, Plaza Lila, Palace Radisson Blue, Mr. Virender, and family Jodhpur and Jaipur Greens.
Universities, Galgotias Universities, Gautam Buddh Universities, Sharda Universities, Bimtik and Holy Family Hospital. We thank Mr. Nadim, Mr. Sureka, Mr. Mirza, Mr. Kapil Arora, Mr. Dhaga, Captain Bowa, Ma'am Sangeeta, Roslyn and Nancy, our Nazarene friends, family members of our father, and many more individuals and family who come to celebrate their various occasion with us and share their joy and love. We remember you in our daily prayer.
A special thank you to our principals, teachers and staff of all our schools, and especially Father Agnes School, Greater Noida. Your generosity cannot be counted, and especially thanks to George Joseph, our administrator. We also express our gratitude to our seniors who have been helping us in various ways. We appreciate their love for us.
We are grateful to all those who have worked hard to put this beautiful program, especially Ma'am Ritika for preparing the script, and Ma'am Ansi for the fillers, and Ma'am Yashmin, and Sir Pascal Topno. We also express our sincere appreciation to our seniors, Sir Vitter, Sir Edwin, Ruthi, Gopi Bhaiya, Maya Di, Sir Tony, Sir Danish, and Father Jovito for helping us with music and songs, and Ma'am Teresa, Chanchan, Tarzi, and Mother Caroline Rina for preparing the dancers.
Teachers Ma'am Anisha and Priya for the costumes, Sir Sahil and Mothers Nirmala and Maggie for the prayer dance, Mothers Lucy and Kiran for preparing the junior choir, Mothers Sujata and Alice for the preparing the children for enter march, Sir Joji for training the students for the poem.
Sir Subhash for the PPT, Sir Sushant for managing the technical stuff, Ma'am Deepika Sharma for the monologue. In a special way, we thank Ma'am Ferdos for overall management. We thank Surinder and his team for the decoration. Preeti Rawat and the team for making the flowers. We thank our beloved sisters, Sister Nancy and Sister Meena for the overall management.
A big thank you, Bilu Uncle, for preparing the yummy food. Thank you to everyone for coming today to be part of this day.
Thank you to all.
Now I request all the Balbhavan children, the pass outs, the ones living here, all those in the balcony at the back, to please come forward. The juniors will stand here while the super seniors will get on stage. As we sing, It's a Beautiful Day. This is us signing off to you with love from the Balbhavan family. Request everyone to rise, and I invite Ananya to offer the prayer before meal.
Almighty God, I praise you, I thank you, hallelujah, mercy and praise. That you have
Eastern and us today.
Continue to bless us, Lord.
So that
be with one another.
As
a lover. Bless our father.
Sisters.
Mothers,
teachers,
Halifactors, and all those
take
care of us.
That is our way.
Stand before the Yosin number.
We also remember.
Poor
and the needy.
Best and poor.
Best and poor.
Amen.
Amen.
Dear friends, now we go for the last item of the day, the lunch. go to the ground and enjoy yourselves.